Amen. Therefore, my With a glory. Blessed is the way whereupon you walk today, O soul, for a place of rest. It is prepared for you. Wisdom. A reading from the first letter of the Thessalonians of the Apostle Paul. Please be seated. Let us be attentive. Brethren, I do not want you to be unaware about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God through Jesus bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with the word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of the Lord, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be.
Should he happen to come at midnight or before sunrise and find them prepared,
Imię Ojca i Syna i Świętego Ducha. Amen. Sława Jezusu Chrystu. In the Old Testament, at the first Passover, a lamb was sacrificed for every household. And the blood of that lamb was smeared over the lintels of each home. And seeing the blood of the lamb over a doorway, death passed by, or passed over that home. The angel of death passed over as the people sat in their homes, dressed and prepared to leave at any moment, with their lamps lit, partaking in that Passover meal, and eating of the lamb that had been sacrificed. That night was a night of vigil for the Lord, when he brought them out of the land of Egypt and slavery, bondage in that land. And all future generations would mystically partake in that first exodus out of the bondage of slavery through the observance of the Passover. So every Passover, every year, was a night of vigil, a night of watching, kept to the Lord by all the people of Israel throughout their generations. Exodus chapter 12, verse 42. All of Israel, in the observance of the Passover, in a mystical way, takes part in the original Passover when death passed by their doors and the Lord came to them and led them out of the bondage of Egypt in the first Exodus, a journey that would bring them to the promised land. And on that journey, God would provide for them. He would nourish them with the bread, the manna that fell from heaven. Dear brothers and sisters, in the gospel that we heard today, Jesus is speaking about a new Passover that is to take place, and a new Exodus. In this new Passover, he will become that innocent Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world, who takes it upon himself and carries them to the cross. By his innocent death and perfect sacrifice, he will redeem us, in other words, buy us back, not from slavery in Egypt, but to buy us back from the slavery to sin and death. In this new Passover, it is Christ who passes over death. In other words, he conquers it. In the first Passover, death passed over. But in this new Passover, Christ passes over death, sin and death, and he conquers it. And so what begins is a new exodus, a new journey out of this fallen world to new and eternal life in the kingdom of God. It's the kingdom of God in the new exodus that is the new promised land. Those who are washed in his precious blood, in the mystery of baptism, partake in this Passover. They become part of the new Exodus. And during this journey to the promised land, the kingdom of God, they are nourished by the very body and precious blood of the risen Lamb for the forgiveness of sins and life everlasting. And this bread comes miraculously down from heaven. Christ has passed over death and conquered it. And whenever we celebrate the Eucharist, as we do today, we partake in his death and his resurrection, and we are nourished by him until he comes for us and brings brings us home. As we heard in today's gospel reading, Jesus calls upon his disciples to be ready, to be prepared to go with lamps of faith lit burning brightly, just as the people of Israel during that night of the first Passover waiting patiently upon the Lord. And blessed is the slave whom the master finds ready and alert when he comes. Dear brothers and sisters, we are reminded today that Jesus, the Son of Man, is coming. He is coming at an hour that we do not expect or know. First, he's coming at the moment of our own death and departure from this world. And he is also coming at the end of this age, at the moment of his glorious return and the final resurrection of the dead. Today, that hour has come for our brother in the Lord, Ihor. Our Lord has come for him. In baptism, he was washed in the precious blood of Christ for the forgiveness of all his sins. He was then released from the bondage to sin and death, for Christ has passed over death and has conquered it. In the Eucharist, Ihor became part of that new exodus, the journey out of this world to the promised land, the kingdom of God. And during that journey, throughout his life here on earth, he was nourished by that new manna, the bread of life that comes down from heaven. And today, the Lord has come for his servant Ihor, a faithful servant, prepared for his master, with the light of his faith burning brightly within. Ihor follows the Lord and enters on that final blessed way, the final part of the journey that brings him home to the kingdom of God. Blessed is the way upon which you walk today, O soul, for a place of rest is prepared for you. May the Lord grant eternal rest to his servant Ihor, and may he grant him eternal remembrance. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Oh. Oh.
нам сидять кичен, Богом бережний народ наш, спродивився військо, благородних і преснопам'ятних дітурів, доброчинців храму цього. Нехай Господь Бог помине в царстві своїм, душу спочило своє слово ім'я, які перестануся від нас. Нехай Господь Бог помине в царстві своїм, всіх нас, православних християн, завжди нині про цей час і на віки вічні.
The Father and the Son, He is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us stand now. Let us stand with fear. Let us be attentive to offer in peace the holy oblation.
The mercy of peace, the sacrifice of praise.
For us, Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with all. which is in this chalice, the precious blood of your Christ, changing them by your Holy Spirit. So that they may be for communion, sobriety of soul, forgiveness of sins, fellowship of your Holy Spirit, fulfillment of the kingdom of heaven, confidence before you, not for judgment or condemnation. Further, we offer this rational and unworthy worship to those who have gone to their rest in faith, forefathers, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, and saints, and for every righteous soul that finished this life in faith. Especially for our most holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady, the Mother of God and Heavenly Virgin Mary.
Oh.
страшному суді Христовому просі.
Подай, Господи,
часті Святого Духа випросивши самі себе і один одного і все життя наше, Христу Богові віддаємо.
Сину Божий, мене причасником прийми, у ворога план твоїм кам'яним повім, і поцілунку не дам тобі, як Юда, але як розбійник сповідаюся тобі. Поміни мене, Господи, коли прийдеш у царстві твоїм. Поміни мене, Владико, коли прийдеш у царстві твоїм. Поміни мене, Святий, коли прийдеш у царстві твоїм. Нехай не на суд і не на осудження буде мені причастя святих твоїх тайн, Господи, а на зцілення душі і тіла. Боже, милостивий будь мені грішному. Боже, очисти гріхи мої і помилуй мене. Без числа грішив я, Господи, прости мені.
Please rise.
Now and forever.
loves wisdom, and he loves mankind.
Слава Ісусу Христу!
Слава Богу!
Can you hear me? My name is Chris Dmytruk. I'm Ihor's older brother. Today we are celebrating Mass for Ihor, who at age 83 passed away after a lengthy illness and progressively declining health. There are two distinct aspects to Ihor's life. Namely, his professional part and his human part. Ihor was born in Kamianka-Buzka in Ukraine on February 11, 1938. His parents were Eugene and Leonida Dmytruk, and he has three brothers, me, Eugene, and Rostislav. As World War II was happening, the family fled Ukraine. After living in Stivoy and Graz in Austria from 1944 to 1949, Our family immigrated to Canada in 1949. After first living in Edmonton for 3 months until April of 1950, we moved to Lamont where we lived until 1958, and then we moved back to Edmonton. When we were in Edmonton, our sister Susanna joined us. It was in Sheboy that Ihor started grade one and continued his education in Graz and then in Lamont where he completed his high school education. During high school years, Ihor excelled in track and field and basketball. We had an inter-school basketball league, and Ihor's accurate play were a major contributors to us winning many, many games. It was during his high school years that Ihor first demonstrated his artistic abilities when he created small sculptures in wood and in other media. And that is when he first discovered his ability in art. He created posters for my election when I was running for the Students Union president. After high school, we were enrolled at the University of Alberta, and he studied art, and in 1961 was awarded the Intermediate Diploma in Art. He continued his art studies at what is now known as the Emily Carr University and Design. On graduation, he was granted the honors advanced diploma in drawing and in painting, and received the Jack Ball Award for excellence in drawing and graphics. His professional career commenced in 1963. At first, he shared his studio with his art friends in downtown Edmonton. Then he purchased his own duplex in the Milbury Ravine. He added a studio on the second floor where he thereafter continued to create his art. He was very innovative and periodically changed the direction of his creative abilities. His artistic activities were recognized when he received the Canada Council Graphic Award, the All Alberta Exhibition Honorable Mention Award in 1966, and the Canada Council Grants in 1972-1974. Ihor's art was exhibited at 7 solo exhibitions and in 30 group exhibitions held in various Canadian galleries in Japan, the United States, and in Kingdom, United Kingdom. His works can be found in public, corporate, and private collections. Many, many articles have been written about him in various Canadian art journals. I would now like to turn to his human side. He was a religious person and always attended church services and followed other religious practices. Being a very caring person, Ihor always was ready to help and ask. He was a loving and caring brother, son, and uncle. One could not have asked for a better one. His great nephews and nieces loved him. His compassionate nature was clearly demonstrated by the support he gave to our parents until our father died in 1985 and my mother's until she was died in 2000. When mother was living alone, he looked after her as her prime caregiver. When he returned home from evening classes at the university or other places, he always checked up on her. He did her shopping and took her to appointments and others. They had a ritual of always having dinner together on Sunday. Even though his income was quite meager and not great, he always was generous and brought gifts to birthday parties or gave gifts at Christmas times. He liked company and hosted dinners at his house and in restaurants. He always came to birthdays, Easter and Christmas dinners, and other family events when invited. It's hard to summarize the various memories, events, and happenings from so many years ago. Both in Shimon and Graz, the four of us brothers always played together and defended each other if a need arose. I recall a situation when we were playing in Graz in the city park, and we were attacked by some other boys. We fended them off. It was like the four musketeers, one for all and all for one. I recall a situation in Lamont when you and I visited our grandmother who lived in a farmhouse across the hill. There we had drank some fermented apple cider. It made us happy and giggling walking home. But did we have fun? We sure did. The apartment in Graz was small where we lived. To get out of the house, mother would send us into the park, and we had to practice the sayings in the mass. One of us would say the priest part, and the other one the people's part. This is how I learned the people's part at the time. When I purchased my first car in 1960, Ihor and I decided to go to Bedford. We bypassed Calgary not knowing where the gas stations are. We kept driving west, and we were low on gas. We got as far as Morgan Reserve and parked by their gas stations, and went to sleep in the car and to wait. We were woken in the morning by the security guard tapping on our window, and we had to explain to them as to what the situation was. They sold us some gas and told us to move on. We got as far as the Bow Alley Provincial Park and parked for the night and fell asleep in the car. When we woke up in the morning, we saw the Rocky Mountains. We had not seen mountains since we left Austria, since we lost Austria. Seeing the mountains again created a big impression that has remained with us. It's just amazing. All of a sudden, we come and you see these mountains in front of you. It was in later years, we were always like traveling. In later years, he would join Rusty and his family at the Grammar Resort and in other trips that he went into the mountains. Ihor was proud of his Ukrainian heritage and has in his collection many, many Ukrainian artifacts. He traveled to Ukraine in 1993 and visited the places where he lived as a child. During the trip, we reconnected with our family in Lviv and maintained contact, regularly corresponding with them and sending the pictures of our family functions. Ihor had a good ear for music, and for a short time played the violin and the mandolin, but gave it up to pursue art. This is a very brief overview of some aspects of Ihor's life and what type of person he was. The family would like to express gratitude to Dr. Mushafi for the dedicated medical care provided to him over the years. The family also expresses thank you to Lee Bernudo, her longtime friend and caregiver, for all the help she has provided to him over the years. Ihor also was blessed by having wonderful neighbors, Rob and Evelyn Kostek and Alan Gillespie. Thank you for all the help that you provided to him over the years. In closing, our family thanks you for joining us at this funeral service, and for thus honoring our brother, by your presence. Please join us in the Hall of Cross to have you for lunch and fellowship following the completion of the church service. And interment will follow in St. Michael's Cemetery after the lunch. Please be careful when you go to the hall. The sidewalks and parking lot is quite icy. Thank you for your attention. Thank you, Gabriel.
Thank you. the plank. Step right up. Take your time.
Come on.
Set it down. Or? A little more. Lift up. Okay, here we go.
Forward.
Hold on.
There is no one who will live and will not sin, for you alone are sinless.
Your justice is everlasting justice, and your word is true. For you, O Christ, our God, are the resurrection, the life, and the repose of your servant Ihor, who has fallen asleep. And we give glory to you together with your eternal Father and your most holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and forever and ever.
Amen. Славнішові Серафимі, що без утління Бога Слово породила, сущу Богородицю тебе величаємо.
Слава тобі, Христе Боже, надія наша, слава тобі!
Славоцю і Сину, і Святому Духові, і нині повсякчас, і на віки вічні. Амінь. Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй. Благослови.
Christ, our true God, who has power over the living and the dead, through the prayers of his Immaculate Mother, of the holy, glorious, and all praise with the apostles, of our venerable and godly fathers, and of all the saints, who will place the soul of his servant Ihor, who has departed from us, in the abodes of the just, and will give him rest in the bosom of Abraham, and number him among the just, and will have mercy on us and save us, for he is good, and he loves mankind.
Amen.
The earth is the Lord's, and the fullness thereof, the world, and all who live in it. Earth, dust, and ashes is what you are, and therefore, according to the will of God, you return to the earth once again. May your memory be eternal. This grave is sealed until the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In blessed sleep, grant eternal rest, O Lord, to your ever to be remembered servant Ihor, and make his memory everlasting. Ублажені му спині вічні упокій подай, Господи, повсякчас поміненому слузі Твоєму Ігореві, і вчини йому вічною пам'ю.
Вічна.
Sincerest thanks to all of you who are present to your prayers today. We're standing by the family, but also standing by the soul of the servant of God, Ihor, as he makes his final journey. Our sincerest prayers and also our sincerest condolences to the grieving family. May the Lord bless you and we grant you the consolation that you need at this time. Slava Jesus Christus!
Slava Jesus Christus!